The naughty girl is back for part two. I promised that I was going to come back at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'm 8 minutes late, but I still made it anyway. So that's the most important thing. And we thank the Lord for another opportunity to continue to be well behaved in this video. So I'm going to try and keep this one succinct. I did promise that I was coming to come talk about osteoarthritis, something that is very dear to my heart, a topic that can make me potentially very emotional. So I am keeping a handle on my emotions. I'm taking charge of my emotions. And somebody would ask the question, but why don't you just title the video osteoarthritis so that we can know what we're watching? You see, when you're on social media, you have to understand social media. Social media, being a social place, doesn't really push videos that have to do with wellness and health that much. But we still have to talk about what we have to talk about. And so in order to disguise what we are talking about, we also have to figure out ways to survive on this highway. So it also means that you cannot miss any video the Sika Educates puts out there, because you don't know what Sika Educates is going to be talking about. You have to make sure that you're following and watching and catching up on all the videos, including those that you miss out on at the time of the live video, so that you're up on point and abreast with what is being discussed here. If you're here and you want me to know that you are here, you have to send love hearts now. You know how we do it here. Keep the love hearts coming. I haven't seen one love heart pop up my screen yet. So I'm guessing that you don't want me to talk. You want me to end this video and go back to bed. I can do that. If that is what you want me to do, I can go back to bed. But if you want me to genuinely share my thoughts on this huge topic, please, I need to see some love hearts. I think I've seen one or two so far. I need you to keep them coming. Keep the love hearts coming, the red button. Please keep your fingers on that one. And let's get the show very much on the road. Okay, good afternoon to everybody. Mr. Kwame, good afternoon. Sister Valerie, good afternoon. Mr. Stephen, good afternoon. Felicitas, Florence, good afternoon to everybody. And welcome, welcome, welcome to this platform. Okay. What is osteoarthritis? What is that? It's a medical condition that affects the joints of human beings, especially your knee, your hip, your spine, and your hands. It can affect just about any joint, but those are the predominant places that osteoarthritis can affect. It affects some people in their ankle as well. But the main joints that normally have osteoarthritis is the knee, the hip, the hands, the spine. What at all is it? It is a degenerative issue, meaning that it continues to progress and worsen over time, medically speaking. And it causes inflammation and swelling and pain, discomfort around those joints, and makes mobility and movement of those joints excruciatingly painful. When I started doing this video, I did mention that it's a very sensitive topic for me. It's an emotional one for me. And the question is why? Why? Because I am a sufferer of osteoarthritis. I have osteoarthritis in my knees. I have osteoarthritis in my ankles, and I have osteoarthritis in my hip. So when I'm telling you that I know what can happen when you have osteoarthritis, trust me, I've been there. It's another condition that I have tried to come to terms with and deal with for over 3 decades of my life. So I think that I've earned the right to become a bit of an expert in this area, just based on my own personal experiences and what I've been through. A lot of the incisions that I've had on my body have been as a result of that, trying to realign the bones and do all sorts of craziness. Unfortunately, some of those surgeries ended up being botched, which means that instead of fixing the problem, whoever it was made it worse. And so now trying to fix something that has been botched is a very difficult procedure and process to go through. Is it all doom and gloom? Does it mean that, you know, I'm helpless? There's nothing I can do about this. How does it come about? What are some of the symptoms that you'd experience when you have this condition? And what can you do to make your life that much easier? That is why we're here. Good afternoon to everybody. My name is Sika Antonio, and you're welcome to this live video, Mr. Yao. You're welcome. Kunedu, you're welcome. Sister Bernice, you're welcome. Adetola, you're welcome. Good afternoon to everybody. So this degenerative condition, this, you know, discomfort that you're feeling inside your body, this swelling, this pain, this tenderness, this dis-ease, that is working its way at your joints. Why does it happen? Why? Like, how does it come about? You see, when you look at every joint, I'll use my wrist as an example because it's the easiest joint that I can show you on this live video and you can see it. So this is my wrist, right? This joint where my hand and my arm connect to each other. At every joint like that, there are two bones that are fusing together. So when I want to move my wrist in a particular way, you know, the bones should be able to be flexible and do whatever maneuver I'm trying to do in this joint, for example, right? Now, the two bones that are fusing together, in the middle of the bone is something called cartilage. For those of us who love chicken, when you get the chicken from the shop and you're, you know, marinating it ready to roast, or you're cutting it up into pieces, when you're trying to detach the leg or the thigh of the bone from the rest of the chicken, there's this white substance that covers the bones. And when we're cutting it, we're trying to make sure that we're cutting it in such a way that the cartilage remains on the chicken thigh. A lot of children like that bone because it's really soft and chewy and it's very nice, right? That bone, that cartilage, we have it in all of our joints. Sister, Auntie Elaine, how are you doing? Sister Fia, how are you? Miss Ikua, how are you? Lamin, Sister Teresa and Sister Fia, I hope you are all doing well. So this joint, right, it has this bone in my hand and this bone in my arm, and they're connected together. They meet at this joint, and in between that, there's cartilage, that white substance. What does it do? The cartilage is in place to make sure that when your bones are twisting, you want to raise your hand. So, you know, your joint is doing, your hand bone is doing this, the other one is at a different angle. That turning of the bones, that there is no friction that is happening, that is leading to, oh, I'm glad that you're fine, Auntie Lynn. I miss you so much. You know, that the joints in the bones making those kinds of maneuvers, that the cartilage is in place to soak up all the pressures from the two bones with the different maneuvers that are taking place. If you have osteoarthritis, unfortunately, what happens is that as those maneuverings are happening in the joints, your cartilage starts to wear off over time. Is grinding, the bones are, you know, doing all those twisting, and the cartilage that is the sandwich in between them starts to erode as those movements are being done time after time, different times in a day, so many times in a day over the course of the days, the weeks, and the months. Now, as this cartilage begins to wear, the bones, if it wears enough, you now become bone to bone. So instead of there being cartilage between the bones, now the bones are grinding each other and scratching the surfaces of the bones itself. And don't forget that the bones have veins and blood vessels connected inside it. so that you can have feeling and sensation in your bones, so that your bones can have oxygen to be able to function and your bone doesn't completely fall apart. So as this cartilage wears, your bones start to disfigure because your bones were never made to be hitting each other. There was supposed to be that barrier between them to protect the surfaces of the bones and to make sure that the shape of those huge bones are preserved. So similarly, in your hip, that ball and socket joint between your pelvis, the pelvic bone of your spine, and the thigh bone that is entering that hole, that joint there, there should be cartilage there that is protecting. So when you raise your leg, you know, that maneuver, when you put your legs down, when you're bent over at with your knees to the ground and all sorts of things are happening, that, you know, you're doing the bones are able to do the things that they're supposed to do without any issues. So that's what should happen when your bones are normal and, you know, you have the cartilage in there and it's doing what it's supposed to be doing. Unfortunately, for some of us, genetically, so it's no fault of yours, it's in your genes. You're born with it. Unfortunately, some of us in our genes have this debilitating condition. And so you can find several members of a family. They all get to a certain point and they all start having issues with their spine, with their hip, with their knee, with their ankle, all kinds of different joints in the human body. Genetics, there's nothing you can do about it. Aging as you get older as well. You know, this body has been through so much wear and tear. And so these things are bound to happen. And you start having your cartilage, you know, wearing off at an alarming rate to the point that you are now bone to bone in certain places. And the bones are rubbing against each other, you know, rubbing off, chipping off bit by bit over time the surfaces of the bone, which are supposed to be smooth and nice, and now zigzaggy and rough, because the bones, by moving and doing those maneuvers, the friction is scratching off the nice smooth surfaces of your bone. If you haven't really suffered any osteoarthritis, you won't understand the enormity of the pain and what can happen when you're dealing with this kind of condition. For me, it started showing itself very early on. And even before I became a teenager, 10, 11, I was having issues with my knee. I would fall, my knee would swell up, I'd go into hospital, I'll have a cast. Eventually, they said, oh, they needed to pull some muscles to hold the kneecap in place. And this is where the botching of that operation happened, to ruin my knees completely. And so unfortunately for me, I've had to have metal plates put in certain parts of my knee to try and hold it in place and to get it to do what it needs to do. And having any foreign material in your eye, in your hip or your knee or any joint, it's not funny. It hurts like crazy. One thing that osteoarthritis doesn't deal very well with is damp and cold. So if you live in an extremely cold place, that is also damp on top of it, you're in big trouble. In Calgary, it is freezing cold, so it hurts, that's true. But at least it's dry cold. And I've actually found that the sort of pain that I was having, discomfort, that I was having when I was living in England is 10 times worse than what I have in Calgary, Alberta, even though Calgary is 20 times more cold than Britain. Why? Because the island of the United Kingdom is wet, cold, damp, cold. There's always moisture in this air. Whereas in Canada, in Alberta specifically, because on the East Coast, they have similar temperatures and temperaments to Britain. But in the West Coast where I'm at, Calgary, Alberta, where I'm at right now, the cold is a drier kind of cold. We're surrounded by mountains. It's freezing. Yes, it's cold, but it's not a damp cold. It's a dry cold. So cold is painful all around, but at least what I have now is a drier cold. So cold and damp doesn't help with all the swelling and inflammation and all of the things that are going on. It just makes the bones soak in that's much more of the cold and makes it hurt. Why does it hurt when you live in a colder place? It's because when it's cold, all the nerves and the muscles around that joint, they become constricted. They stiffen up. And there's nothing worse than the vessels that are supposed to supply blood to your bones being in tension and constricted. It hurts like hell. So as the cartilage around your bones continues to deteriorate, there are all kinds of things that medics will try to do for you. But before we go into that, I wanted to talk about some of the telltale signs that maybe this is what is happening. There are different kinds of arthritis. Today we're talking about osteoarthritis, which is just the degeneration of the cartilage and the bones itself. There is also rheumatoid arthritis, which is more of an autoimmune condition. So we can talk about that on a separate day, but we are talking today specifically about osteoarthritis. What are some of the symptoms? I've talked about one of them, which is excruciating pain. When you try to move the joint, it hurts. So when I sit down for a long period of time and I suddenly want to get up, my knees hurt. You have discomfort in your knees for not being able to, you haven't moved the joint for a long time. Oh, thank you, Pastor Patience. You haven't moved the joint for a long time. So when you suddenly put movement in it, it hurts. Excruciating pain is one of the symptoms of osteoarthritis. The other thing is that you have a lot of stiffness around the joints. As I said, the muscles and the nerves that are there, they become constricted when it's cold. It's like everything around my knees in tension. All the nerves are like this around the bone and it hurts. It puts pressure on the kneecap or wherever your pain happens to be, your discomfort happens to be, and it hurts like crazy. The other thing is just tender, like it's tender to touch. Even when you touch the knee, the hip, your wrist, wherever the pain is, the discomfort is, the osteoarthritis is, it is always tender. Sometimes it looks like it is puffy because it's swollen, because all the nerves and the blood vessels around it are also inflamed. There's a lot of inflammation going on around the joint. Sometimes you have fluid-like pockets around in between the bones where the cartilage should be. It feels like there's this fluid that is there and it hurts too. You also feel this grinding when you're climbing the stairs. Some people who have arthritis can maybe speak to this. When you're trying to climb stairs or do any funny maneuvers, you hear this grinding. It's as if your bones are grinding, or sometimes it pops. But for me, it's grinding. It makes this grr kind of sound. You know, it's like something is grinding. Something is crackling. And it's because of the rubbing of the bones against each other. That wasn't how God intended it to be. Cartilage was supposed to be in between those things to keep everything nice, moist, and fluid. But this cartilage is wearing off over time. You start to lose flexibility in your joint where it hurts. Because as people, that's how we are. When you have discomfort doing a particular thing, you're less likely to do that thing because it hurts. And so when you have osteoarthritis, the temptation is great to just sit in one place, don't move, Don't walk. Don't do anything. Just stay in one place because moving hurts. But unfortunately, the truth about it is that we humans were made for motion. And so although it hurts, if you make that mistake of remaining in a sedentary position for long periods of time, you make your situation 50 times worse. And if you don't take care, you may never walk again. Because the more you put it off, the more you sit at one place, the more you stop using or have function for that muscle and that joint that is hurting, the less mobility you have in there. And over time, you can be a 50-year-old and find that now you can't walk unaided. You have to have walking stick. You have to have Zimmer frame. You have to have crutches. You need something, some kind of aid in order to be able to move. So although it hurts, you're in discomfort, the medics will tell you that the body is made for motion. And the only way to keep things happening is to ensure that the joints are always moving as much as it hurts. It doesn't have to be any excessive kind of motion. Walking doesn't put too much pressure on you. So, you know, walk around. Do things with your joints. Oh, Pastor P, let's not go there. Osteoarthritis makes it hard to live your life, I tell you. I tell you, at the age of 11 was when this osteoarthritis thing started for me. 11, imagine. You fall, it swells, your knee is in a cast, you have crutches, back and forth, ups. Let's not get started. It hurts, plain and simple. You then develop spurs. As I said, let's say this is the bone that is inside your thigh that is connecting to your pelvic. And let's say that this is your pelvis. So then the thigh bone connects to your pelvis here. And this is your pelvic bone and the thigh bone goes in there. And, you know, that's how your legs are. There is supposed to be cartilage between this surface here and that surface there, so that both of them can maintain the smoothness whilst this bone is trying to get inside that one. And this is your thigh to your leg and this is your pelvic bone. If the cartilage here on top of this, I'm trying to see what substance I can use as cartilage. So let's say this pink thing here is your cartilage and it's here. So this is it. This is your thigh bone. This is the cartilage. And this one is your pelvic, right? If this cartilage starts to wear off and wear off and wear off and now there's no more cartilage and this bone is now touching this bone to bone. Every time you move your thigh bone, it will be rubbing this one. This one will also be rubbing it, rubbing. So both of them are rubbing. Over time, this won't have the smooth surface that God made it to have. This wouldn't have the smooth surface that God made it to have. So now you have rugged looking bone surfaces like this. Your bone will start to look like this, rugged like that. Have that, you know, bread knife, how the bread knife looks with that jagged. That's how the bones become, because the cartilage that is supposed to be the protective covering has been removed completely, or most of it is gone. Sometimes when medics look at the images of my knees, sometimes I've had some of them ask me, so how are you able to walk? Does it not hurt? And I'm like, I know, but I'm getting on with it, right? Because I'm almost bone to bone. If I was older, they would probably, I'll probably be primed for knee replacement. But that comes with its own set of issues. And so they wait until, you know, you can't do anything about it until you get to that point, and that is the treatment that they give you for it. I've lived with this for 32 years of my life. And so, like I said, I've become some kind of an expert with this whole thing. When you suspend your body in water, water therapy, some kind of swimming, because water takes over your weight. And so you're able to move the joints and exercise them. It does help a lot. Absolutely, when I put my feet into the hot springs, I don't know whether you caught some of the pictures, but my Russian family and I went to BC in the summer months, and at least two times we ended up in the hot springs. It was like heaven on earth. The water was just so warm. It's so warm naturally. It's not like they've heated it up or anything. It's just hot in the springs in the middle of mountains. Oh, it's to die for. And it was so therapeutic for me and so warm, just like the right temperature, because for once, it's like you can't feel any discomfort at all. It was heaven on earth. And it's really, really good for you. So if you're able to do that, if you have a jacuzzi with warm water and you can put yourself in there, it's an amazing thing to be able to do. Now, as I said, it's aging and genetics, and sometimes when you're on the heavier side, being obese, it makes that whole process, it hastens that whole process for you. So that's not a very nice thing to be happening to you, but it's kind of like a catch-22 event, because you can't move the joints. So of course, if you're not moving much and you're eating, you're gonna put weight on, and then now that you've put the weight on, it's even more difficult for you to move. So it's like, what am I supposed to do? Chicken and egg situation, caught between a rock and a hard place. What am I going to do? Putting unnecessary strain on the knees or the joint, whatever joint it is, also is a very difficult thing that can exacerbate or worsen your osteoarthritis symptoms. If you're very athletic and you have these things in your family, it's crucial for you that you pay attention to your bones and you do what you need to do to protect them, because if you don't, and there's sustained injuries that go on for a long time, you end up with issues that you can't control. They've also found that metabolic conditions, like things that affect your metabolism, like being diabetic, for example, or having this condition they call hemochromatosis or something. I think that is when you have excessive amounts of iron inside your body that is harmful for you. Having extra bones, bone spares, it hurts like crazy. Okay, so what are the things that need to be done to figure out what this osteoarthritis, how do you find it? How do you know? Okay, you have pain, you have inflammation, it's making crackling sounds or grinding sounds. Does that mean I have it? You can only tell for sure by imaging. Your medic may start with x-rays to see. And if the imaging is not clear enough, then they ask you to have magnetic resonance imaging, MRI scans. I can't even count how many MRIs I've had in my lifetime. Like, I've had it for 10 life sentences and some. I've been in that thing. My sisters say that it's like they felt, when they had to have it, it felt like they've been put in a coffin and and they were going to be put 6 foot under. Two of them had to be sedated to be able to do it. And I'm just like, really? This is like the back of my door. I have it every so often. So I've become accustomed to it, because you have to lie still and go through that banging sound for half an hour so that they can see what is happening. And they get the most perfect images of what is happening inside of you on the bones, right? So that's how they are able to find it specifically, that this is what the issues are and what can be done about it. There's so many kinds of treatments that are available, and everyday medicine is advancing. Thank God for medicine. They've done a lot of things that are good. They've helped me save my life. I have anaphylaxis to all kinds of things. Yes. When you have a lot of iron buildup, thank you, Pastor Patience. in your blood, in your body, right? So anyway, some of the treatments that can be given for people who have osteoarthritis is they start with the low or the low hanging fruits, as my mom will call them, and then as they go on, they increase it to other things. So the first thing would be you have to have physiotherapy. They have specific exercises that they ask you to do. You know, not anything high impact, because your knee, your hip, whatever it is already in tension. So they're just trying to help you to find a way of building up the muscles around the affected area so that you can have more flexibility and be able to move the joint. For example, with the knee, they can tie a string to the chair, the leg of your chair, and ask you to put your foot, your leg through it, and use the weight of your knee to push the string so that you can lift your leg up so far and bring it back so far. And keeping that motion back and forth can help. Today, there's a QB bike for those of us who sit and do a lot of sedentary work with our head and our brains. There's the QB bike that you can fit underneath your chair. Let me see if I can lift mine up to show you. It's quite a huge device, but the QB bike is something that you can put underneath your chair. And you can be cycling. That's motion of, you know, gently just doing it back and forth to keep the motion in your knees going. So as I sit and work through the day, talking, videos, whatever, I'm moving my legs frequently to make sure that any fluid that is collecting around the kneecap and the foot and all of that can be easily dispensed and, you know, and removed from the body. Because when you're not moving, you start to retain fluid. Your feet will start to swell up. Your knees are swollen. Movement is so painful. That is the last thing that you want to do when you already have these sorts of issues that are ongoing. Another thing too is that there are all kinds of pain remedies that orthodox medicine has available. Anything ranging from paracetamol or Tylenol, as the North Americans know it to be, to naproxen or Aleve. That's what is naproxen, Aleve, if you know what that is. Ibuprofen, and then you start graduating into other things. Now, if you're like me and you're allergic to all kinds of medications, there's a very big limitation to what I can take. So I'm pretty much left with ibuprofen or naproxen. Anything else, I can have Tylenol as well. Anything else, Fentanyl, Oh, I had fentanyl once too, but I had it in surgery. They gave me morphine before and I nearly died. Oh, I was covered in the most horrendous bumps all over my body for weeks. To clear that was something else. They had to flush it out. But, oh, tramadol is suicidal. That makes me hallucinate, vomiting. I was admitted into hospital. Cocodamol, the same thing. So, no, none of those. I can't have none of that. Fentanyl, on the other hand, yeah, it gives you an out-of-body experience. So I had this really painful surgical procedure, and the pain was insane. And so having fentanyl in the hospital was like heaven on earth. You know, every so often they come in and they turn the dial gauge and it pumps a little bit of it into you, and it's like you're in heaven. You cannot feel a thing. But too much fentanyl can take you out like that. Pump too much fentanyl inside your bloodstream, you're just going to fall asleep and not wake up. So they never ever give fentanyl to anybody unless it's under medical supervision in a hospital. This thing is put in a cage with all kinds of labelings all over it. If you are prescribe that thing to somebody, you have to write everything when you put it, the time and everything, because if they put too much at one point, somebody's going to be on the line and held liable for taking somebody out before their time. You know, and sometimes I'm very surprised at how much faith we are able to put into medics. I don't knock them. I love them to bits. I have family members, friends, family that are all medics. Some past, some present, some have retired, some are ongoing. I have nothing but love and respect, the utmost respect for medics in my life and outside of it. I've had some fantastic ones and some absolute nightmares as well in my lifetime. But they're human beings and they're susceptible to human error, for things to happen, for things to get missed out, and for, unfortunately, for you to be the sacrificial lamb that ends up being slain. There are also other things like cortisone injections. And the jury is out about that, whether it really is effective. Some people swear by it, that without it, they wouldn't know what they would do. And some of us don't really, not really sure whether it does anything or actually makes it worse, the symptoms that you experience. And so the jury is out for them. Some people absolutely swear by it. They say it works for them and it's, you know. And for other people, maybe not so much. There are other things like Duralane and lubrication jabs also that can be, you know, can be put in there to help lubricate the joints and make it more, you know, moist and lubricated, to cut back on the friction and the rubbing, therefore the spares that come as a result of that, and just make it a bit more bearable for people. It works for some, it doesn't work for other people. I've also found now that there's this nerve therapy thing. They make tiny holes and incisions around the nerves to do with your knee also, to try and alleviate some of the pressure and see if that helps you to be able to deal with that. Other, you know, unconventional things that some people claim works for them is omega fish oils, which, hey, they're good things. We have to have supplements in our bodies that are going to help us to be able to be better. Acupuncture is another thing that people swear by. I've had it in the past. You know, it's helped me with all kinds of things before. Glucosamine is also another supplement that people take. And the ones that have chondroitin infused with it seems to work better for people that have joint-related issue. I know for sure that my parents take them and swear by them that it helps. So, you know, do whatever works best for you. But this is what I have been doing for the last 16 months that has given me a lot more results over and above what has been happening. Because as I said, I've been with this condition for the best part of 32 years of my life. And so I can feel differences when differences occur. 16 months ago, Pastor Patience did the huge honor of introducing me to redox signaling molecules. She's been an absolute godsend in my life. I don't know where I would be and what I would do without her. I love her more than sense. She knows it. And she'll tell you every day that every single morning, I think she's probably even fed up with this broken record of mine. Pastor P, thank you so much for everything. I don't know what I'll do without you tomorrow. Pastor Patience, thank you so much. Because that's just how I feel. Redox signaling molecules have made such a difference in my life. So prior to Redox, yeah, I had all these things, cortisone, this, every 3 months I was having one shot or another. Today it's inflamed. Last year, we were naughty. The people that I work with, we went on demo. We went on demonstration. We did demo, and whilst we were demoing, there was a lot of Afrobeat that was played, and me, I can't sit still when there's Afrobeat. Somebody got a boogie. And in this boogieing, I had forgotten what was happening in my body. Like, it's like, you know what, just whatever. I just want to have fun. This is such an excruciating experience in the thick of winter when there's so much snow around and I'm freezing cold, and you want me to stand demoing for 7 hours. No, there has to be some boogieing going on. So there was a lot of music and I was boogieing, and I forgot that there are certain maneuvers that I have to be very careful when I'm making those. So there I was boogieing, trying to go down on this boogieing and going down and down. And then when I tried to get back up again, my knee said, I got you. I told you not to do this. You didn't listen. I've got you. So now, all of a sudden, I have to be bundled up in a car and sent home. And now, I have to be non-weight bearing for weeks on end. This was when I had started and embarking on this redox signaling molecules. I came home thinking, oh my God, I am finished. This is going to be me for the next 6 months. How am I going to cope? What am I going to do? But within a few short weeks of applying redox, ingesting some of it, and putting the rest of whatever else Pastor Patient had given me, the gel, topically, in specific areas that she knows to put it, and applying it consistently. Give it a couple weeks and I was as good as new, and I was still boogieing. I hadn't listened to advice, so I was still boogieing. I wanted to make sure that, you know, the redox was redoxing. And I'm still here. I'm still here. I've had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 incisions. All under general anesthetic on my legs alone. 3 of them on one leg, 4 of them on the other. So actually that's 7, isn't it? Yeah. On my body. Just my knees and, you know, from my hip down to my feet. 7 of them over there. So you can just imagine. I have metal stuff in one of the knees. So when I get to the airport and I'm going through security, I already tell them, please, I have metal plates in my knee. So don't come and tell me I've put anything there. This is what is happening. And they start laughing. So that is what was going on prior to coming across redox. You see, what at all is redox? I've been laughing about redox all day, but what is redox? What is redox? You see, we human beings, anything that lives, moves, and has been on the surface of this planet is made up of cells. Your eyes, this eye of mine, it has a lot of cells in there. My nose, cells. Mouth, cells. My hair, cells. Every part of your body is made up of trillions of cells. These cells come together to make tissue, organs become systems, systems become you. So your reproductive system, for example, if you're a man, your bula matali, the donuts, that's the fire engine behind that, those two donuts, those ones, the wheels, that one, together with your scrotal sac and everything around that, that is your reproductive system. If you're a sister, the punani, the cervix, the womb, the fallopian tubes, the ovaries, that is your reproductive system. Each one of those things is made up of cells. Your leg, your thigh, your bones, your ankle, everything is made up of cells. Now, in the cells, there's a specific part of it that is called the mitochondrion or the mitochondria. We English, that's how we say it. So Americans have their own way of saying it. I can't say it. English say mitochondria. Pastor Patience will say it differently. I don't want to bite my tongue. Mitochondria, right? Now, in this mitochondria, when you eat food, This mitochondria is what is able to make proper energy out of what you've eaten to keep your cells functioning, be able to do the things that the cells need to do in your body. But a mitochondria has an even more fundamental, I would say more important function and role to play, and that is that it produces redox signaling molecules by the trillions inside of your body. What is the purpose of having redox inside of you? The cells in your body need to be able to coordinate and communicate with each other so that when your husband wants to come and see you, your brain would tell Punani, hey, my sister, you have to get ready. Oga Mwachuku wants to see you tonight. So my sister, start getting relaxed, start opening, start doing what you must do because Papa Chioma needs to see you tonight. Likewise, the brain must also connect to Bula Matali and be telling him that Papa Nkechi, Mama Ijeoma wants to see you tonight. So please, don't go and sleep on the job. Oh. Don't go and do 6:30 at night. Wake up. When Mama Chioma gives you the signal, Papa Ijeoma, you have to wake up and perform to the highest horsepower and show Mama Chioma that you know what's going down. If your brain and your Bula Matali are not communicating properly, so when Mama Chioma is giving you signal, oh God, make you wake up now, don't give me the thing now, make I sleep, and then you are not hearing it, eh? Your Bula Matali is as cold as anything. Instead of doing a 10:30, it is at 6:30 at rest. Eh? No matter how much Mama Chioma is trying desperately for these cells of yours to wake up, it is still falling asleep. Very annoying. Very annoying. And this thing is still doing 6:30. Instead of being at 9:30, standing akimbo, attention, and doing the right thing. Most annoying experience. Then there's a problem. It means that your cells are not coordinating and communicating with each other. The cells in your brain and the cells in your Bula Matali and your Punani, they don't hear each other. It's as if the cells in your brain are calling the cells in your Bula, and the Bula is asleep. It can't hear the phone ringing. Or maybe the phone is not even ringing to wake up the Bula to do anything because there's no communication effectively coming through. The signals are gone. And so they can't hear each other. Imagine that you're trying to chew food inside your mouth. And your brain is trying to tell your tummy that there is food in the mouth. It means that very soon it has to go through the esophagus to get inside your tummy. And your tummy is not ready for food. So you try to eat food, it goes into your tummy. And because there is something that is not right in your belly, you eat the food and it goes right through you and comes out the other side. Because the tummy was not ready. All the necessary secretions that need to take place for your tummy to be ready, those things are not happening. And so the food is going down, but it's not doing anything. The phone call is not loud enough for your Bula Matali to hear Mama Chioma's signal that, hey, Oga, I'm ready for my prescription. I want you to give me this injection. Make I sleep. It's not happening. So when these sorts of things are going on inside your body, it's almost as if your house is on fire. You're trying to call the emergency services, the fire brigade, to come and quench this fire for you. And you've picked up your phone and you're calling them. The fire brigade is there. They are ready waiting at the station, but you're calling the station and your call is not getting to the station for them to hear that you're calling them. Imagine what will happen. Your house will burn down. And this is what the redox signaling molecules are meant to be doing inside of our cells, inside of our bodies. Now, these redox signaling molecules, they're already native to your body. What that means is that when you were born, God already knew that you needed redox. So he brought you here with the redox inside your body. It was there already. You were born with it. And so as a baby, the redox was redoxing. Lots of redox signaling molecules were being made by the trillions, and they quickly go to work. And things were happening like clockwork. So if you have a young child, a crawling baby, you know how babies can be problematic. Once they start moving, they want to move everywhere. If you have a coffee table in your living room and you leave a crawling baby, you know them, they want to get into everything. And they go and bump their head on the leg of your coffee table. Or they're trying to get up and they bump their head on the edge, the corner of your coffee table. Yeah, they will scream and shout for 5 minutes. That place may be inflamed. It may actually swell up a bit. And you put ice pack on it. You console the baby. You may even give him or her breast milk. And, you know, be nice to them for a few days. And then it goes. They don't. You can't even see it there again. But you, as your 30 or 40-year-old woman, go and bump your shin against that same coffee table. If you don't take care, it will be 3 months and that place will still be hurting. You will still have discomfort in that place. There may even be blood collected there. So it has this dark color there and it's hurting when you touch it. Excruciating discomfort happening over there. What that simply means is that when you were younger, when you were a baby, you were baby Chioma. Those redox signaling molecules were happening by the trillion. So, it quickly repairs that bump and bruise and it's done. But as you age, your cells are working overtime to keep diseases and discomfort at bay. It's working, it gets tired. So unfortunately, your cells are not able to manufacture and make as much of the redox signaling molecules that it was able to do when you were younger, when you were a baby, when you were a teenager. And there's so many contributory factors to all of that. One of it is aging. Another one is the toxins that are out there. There's so many things that we're exposing our bodies to today. The world and the planet is not as clean as God made it or created it to be, because we've been here for such a long time and we've polluted everything. Today we have something called cell phone, which is what I'm on now doing this live video. We're all enjoying it. But by sitting in front of this camera for a long time trying to explain this thing to you, I'm already exposing myself to toxins from this cell phone. From the light around my phone. The phone has a camera. It has light. That's what you are seeing me through. But I'm exposing myself to toxins. There are toxins all around us. Whether you like it or not. As long as you live here on planet Earth, you're exposed to toxins every single day. Every single moment of every single day. We're exposing ourselves to toxins of all kinds. So When you're exposed to that, also your cells are not able to produce just as much of those redox signaling molecules as you were able to do when you were much younger. Right? Another thing too is that we go through so much stress. So much stress. Your wife is worrying you. Your husband is cheating. Your children are off course. They don't listen to you. You're having wahala from your boss at work. Your own body, you're not feeling well. Your parents are not well. Your sister is sick. There's always something that is going on in our families, in our lives, that is also exposing us to a lot of stress. So there's stress everywhere. Aging, stress, diet, and the toxins out there mean that our cells are simply not able to keep up with everything that is happening. And destroys the cells are slowly but surely being destroyed. So in order to keep things afloat, to be able to stay the same, for your body to be able to function properly, you have to top up the redox signaling molecules that your body was already making, what is already native, already there inside. You want to top up with more of the same so that you can help your cells to continue to signal and communicate effectively. So that when Mama Chioma is telling Papa Nkechi that I want to see you tonight, you must give me this injection, make I enjoy and feel I'm well, well. Bula Matali can respond, "Oh yes, I will be at your service, madam." and do what has to happen. So that when your tummy is supposed to prepare to receive food, it can do the right thing. The right amounts of secretions will happen, and the food gets inside your belly, and your tummy is able to digest it without you having no acid reflux, this, that, indigestion, all kinds of problems that happen to some of us. So that when Papa Chioma and Mama Nkechi do the do at the right time, your fallopian tube can release an egg into your womb, waiting for Papa Chioma to do his do and pour all the exotic, nice juices in there that are going to meet with your lovely little ovary to create a nice pekin that you're both going to enjoy for your lifetime. But if there's any break in signaling and communication through any one of these various things that should happen, things happen. If there's a breakdown of communication between the lens in your eye, your retina, your cornea, all kinds of things are happening. You can't see. If there's a breakdown in communication with my hair and my scalp, my hair won't grow. And these are some of the discomforts and diseases that we are all suffering from. Polycystic ovaries, diabetes, osteoarthritis, hypertension, high blood pressure, nerve damage, stroke, cholesterol, all these things that are happening to us in this world, in this life of ours. So, yeah, you have all these things that are happening. I am not laying any medical claims to say that redox is a fix it for anything. I'm not a medic. I'm not a doctor. I am just sharing my own experiences that I found using redox and what redox has done for me. And it's up to you. If you're really paying attention, you can connect the dots. We cannot lay any medical claims, but you can connect the dots in that if the cells in your body are fortified enough, if they have enough of these redox signaling molecules to function properly, to do what they need to do, how would discomfort come to your body? How? If your cellular level is high, if you have enough redox, if your cells are all in perfect health and wellness, where is discomfort coming from? So let's connect the dots. But I'm saying this again. I'm not a medic. I'm not laying no medical claims that, you know, redox is a cure to anything. I am just sharing my life story on this journey to self-realization and wellness using redox signaling molecules, and specifically talking about osteoarthritis. We've talked about so many different things, infertility, mama and papa. We've talked about so many different things, but I just want us to think about it for a second. It doesn't matter what your issue is, because this thing is not for any specific condition alone. But if the cells in your body have the signaling molecules that are required for it to have any discomfort, any dis-ease, any discomfort that you have in your body will have to leave, because your cells are in perfect tandem and wellness. They are in sync. They can hear each other. They can signal each other. They can communicate to each other. And so, erectile dysfunction, vaginal dryness, all kinds of these horrible things that are destroying things and preventing us from enjoying our happy married lives, all of these things can be pushed at bay because the cells in your body are fortified with enough of the redox signaling molecules that they're able to do what they're supposed to do. And so, my sister, you have osteoarthritis, and for some reason, apparently, this is scientific research is pointing to it that we women are more prone to osteoarthritis than our male counterparts, and they're still researching to find out why that is the case. I suspect that a lot of it will also have to do with the excessive amounts of hormonal issues that we women suffer from, because we get it from literally from puberty to when we reach menopause. Right? So there's so many different things that can happen to us on this journey to wellness. Today we're talking specifically about osteoarthritis, but it's not the only thing. Any dis-ease and discomfort, you are sitting here listening to me, you know what your discomfort is. I know what my discomforts are, and I know the improvements that I have seen. I haven't been to top up my naproxen for months. The last time I went to that clinic, the doctor, are you still here? Have you moved back to England? Or I haven't seen you for a long time. You're normally here every couple months crying for me to give you more things. What? I said, well, God has been good, though. God has been good to me. I found something that is helping me a lot. So, sorry, doctor, but you're not going to see me here often. You are not going to see me here often. My brother, my sister, maybe you are listening to me today. You don't have any discomfort. Everything seems to be perfect in you. You don't have any issue. God bless you. But I'm telling you that the fact that it hasn't come yet doesn't mean it's not brewing. It's there. We all have something, whether you like it or not, it's there. The fact that you haven't had no symptoms yet, you haven't had any headache, you haven't had any elevated blood pressure, you haven't had anything, doesn't mean that there isn't something that's brewing. It's just waiting its time. At the appropriate time, it will show itself out. And that's when you be calling me, calling Pastor Patience. What can I do? I heard you talking about redox, and I should have. So if you're watching me and everything is perfect, my humble suggestion is that you ensure that you maintain that status of everything is okay by fortifying yourselves with enough redox signaling molecules. Because as long as you live on this planet and you're aging, your redox signaling molecules is reducing 1% minimum each year. So if you're 50 today, by the time you reach 51, the reduction is at least minimum 1% less than what it was when you were 50. So by the time you hit 50, if your redox was, let's say, 80, by the time you get to 55, it's now 75, minimum. By the time you hit 60, it's at 70, and so on and so forth. The decline normally is at 10% minimum each decade. If you are like me, and you now have all kinds of discomforts, the decline is even worse. I am absolutely certain and convinced myself, looking at how my whole body has been feeling prior to meeting this redox, that I think my own, it had depleted to like 30% left. That is me. I know what I was feeling. So I can only speak for my own self in my own body. You don't know my body more than me. I know what I was feeling. And I've had 17 incisions on my body. So you can just imagine. For different things. And so my brother, my sister, you mustn't wait until you start having discomfort and dis-ease and this something before you now start calling anybody. If you're well, you need to be proactive about your health. Thank you so much, Pastor Patience. Do the right thing. Do the right thing to ensure and maintain this wellness that you have. Because some people, you know, I'll do it later, procrastinated so much. Unfortunately, I'm not even alive to tell the tale. because they kept putting it off. Oh, I'll do it next year. Let me just finish my house. You know, I have this important project that I need to finish first. I haven't budgeted this one as part of what needs to happen. Really? That when you're 6 foot under, this project will mean nothing. Other people that never sacrificed anything will be the ones that will come and take on this project and enjoy the fruits of your hard labor. So your health and your wellness, there is no price tag you can put on that. When you fortified yourself and you're now okay, you can earn all the money you want. But some of us have it the reverse way. We want to save money. We want to do this. I want to do. You just wait. When I finish building my house, you just wait. I have this thing that I've decided that I must do. When I finish doing it, then I'll get back to you. And for some people, that getting back to you never happens. Other people will say, oh, I can't afford it. It's too much. It's this, it's that. Really? I have seen people who claim they don't have money. But as soon as they are struck by something really serious, even if they have to go and borrow money, all of a sudden they will make $20,000, $50,000 available because this is their life on the line. Why must we wait till we get to that point before we take action? Why? Because the fact that you don't have discomfort doesn't necessarily mean that there isn't anything brewing inside of you. I'll give you a classic example. I felt fine before I started Redox. But one day I went to my medic. I went to see my family doctor. And I needed painkillers for my knee and my EpiPen. For those of you who are medics, my EpiPen jab had expired. I needed to have it because I have anaphylaxis and I can't just be walking around without it. So I went in to go and get a prescription. You can't just buy it over the counter. I needed a prescription to do this. So he said, oh, sit down, you know. Let's check your blood pressure. I wasn't feeling anything. I was okay. I was happy, go lucky as usual, cracking jokes. He was laughing at me, you know, telling me that I have a very deep, cocky English accent and whatever. And he was laughing at me. Okay. Blood pressure taken. 161 over 101. He said, did you come here yourself? I said, yeah. I just walked in, just lived down the road. Are you sure? I said, ah, doctor, why? I came from my house. Here are my keys. What do you mean? Okay, sit down. 10 minutes later, they checked the blood. 157 over. My sister, what is wrong with you? I said, there's nothing wrong with me. Now you're making me panic. What is it? These are some of the things that happen. Why blood pressure is called the silent remover. It doesn't oftentimes give no symptoms. I felt fine. There was nothing wrong with me. I wasn't having any discomfort anywhere. I was fine. But that day, they checked blood pressure and said to me, hey girl, we don't like this one. You have to do something. Otherwise, we're going to have to put you on medication. All that I'm saying, the long and short of all I'm saying is that do not wait to have a nasty surprise that you could have avoided if you just listen to what I'm saying. Very simple thing. And do what needs to be done. This redox can be taken by anybody, even babies. Because if you heard what I said, redox is native to you. It's already inside of you. It's not a fruit juice. It is not an exotic juice. It is not a supplement like, you know, you take vegetable capsules and omega and no. Exactly. And it was very scary, Pastor P, because the way he behaved, it's like I felt like I'd done something wrong. But if I hadn't been there at the right time, I could sleep and not wake up. And that's me. Sika Educates is finished. Things can happen. So please, please. And you know, the sad thing about it is that the people that look like me and you, we are also the ones that have the most chronic diseases and discomforts in this life. We used to think cancers were, you know, synonymous to Oibo. But now, we are the ones that are getting it. If you're a man, prostate, If it's not prostate, it's colon, If you're a woman, same thing. Bobby, We are all getting it. That word, I don't like to say it, so, you know, excuse me. But, yeah, the C word. We are the ones that are getting it all over the place. Ovarian, Cervical, same thing. And it's taking people out that needn't be taken out. All because of these environmental and socio-economical things that we have subjected ourselves to. I'm not saying acquiring, you know, assets is a bad thing. Who doesn't want to build a house? Who in their right frame of mind doesn't want to buy a house or own a house or build a house? Who doesn't want to buy cars and be able to drive around and, you know, be happy and show off what they've been able to achieve? Everybody does. But what is the priority? What should you put in place first? I've seen so many people acquire mansions and houses and vehicles and all kinds of things. Just when they were ready to enjoy, finally retire and relax and travel and do all the things that need to be done. Guess what? Boom. They can't move. They are paralyzed from the waist down. Paralyzed on one side. This, that, you're diabetic, you can't eat this, you shouldn't do that, you mustn't eat this, you can't go here, you can't go there. My darling, your health is something that you can't put any price tag on. And it's important that you fortify yourself. If your redox signaling molecules, you have it in the right quantities and it's signaling how it needs to signal. All the other things that you're taking, all the other things that you're doing to keep things going, all of those things even work better. Let me go there. So you'll be telling me, but I take omega fish oils, I take glucosamine, I've been taking fruits and vegetables, I'm healthy, I eat a good diet, I exercise. Oh, very fantastic. Clap for you. But it still doesn't mean that your cells have enough redox to keep it going. All of those things I've listed are fantastic things. Keep doing them. But your signaling molecules, the redox, you still need to up those so that your body can continue to perform optimally and keep all the discomforts and diseases at bay. And so my brother, my sister, you will feel the difference when you start redoxing. When you start ingesting redox, drinking redox, applying redox topically to your skin and your body, trust me, you feel different. It's not a one-size-fits-all for everybody. Pastor Patience may take redox and within 24 hours, she's felt a massive change in her wellness. I'm not Pastor Patience. She is Patience. I am Sika. Her genetic type is different from my own. Her cellular level is different from my own. Maybe she has good cells, so her cellular level is better than mine. Mine has depleted. I've had 17 incisions. We are not the same. So what she would achieve in a day may take me a month, 2 months, 3 months to achieve the same thing, because our bodies are different. But guess what? Whether it's 3 months or 2 days or 24 hours, the fact about it is that the redox is still redoxing. I am still fortifying myself so with redox, and it's doing what it needs to do in my body, and I'm continuing to feel it. I've intentionally put my hair in a bun to show you my new growth. Do you see that the hairs on the sides of my hair that were eaten by polycystic ovaries and trying to make me bald, artificial dancing crying, trying to cut off my whole hairline and let my hair start from here? You see, it's all coming back on both sides because the redox is still redoxing. I've told you, I've had 17, 10, 5, 2 incisions on my body over the 40 something years of my life. I've been on redox for 16 months and counting. A lot has happened, but there's still more repair that is happening in this body. So me, I am not coming off redox. Redox matters to me more than food. That is how important redox is to me. You can eat or take whatever vitamin or mineral, but what you need to ask is, are those vitamins good? And minerals, are they actually getting into my cells? If your cells are not functioning properly, assimilation is not happening. So you're just throwing your money away. You're telling yourself, oh, I'm taking vitamin D, I take omega supplement, but you are still the same way you are. Those same discomforts and diseases that you're having, you're still having them. Nothing is changing. It could either be that what you're on is not the best product, or secondly, your body just doesn't know what to do with it. Do you know that the vitamins and the exotic fruit juices and all those minerals and things that we take, they're actually foreign to our bodies? They're not native. They can tell you, oh, it's bioavailable and your body would assimilate it. Yeah. But it's not native to your body. Your body doesn't know what it is. When you take naproxen, your body doesn't know what naproxen is. Naproxen needs to go through you, get to your liver. It now has to process it, break it down. Now your body has to, this thing, what is it meant for? Oh, okay, it's a painkiller, okay. Then it will now try to absorb that. And then that is how it works. And that's what it needs to do. And you know, a lot of these orthodox things, all it's doing is masking a deeper problem. You have headache, so they give you a Tylenol. Oh, you can take as much as 2,000 milligrams a day. Don't worry about it. Just take it. Okay. You're not feeling the headache anymore. But that doesn't mean that. Why is my head hurting? Why is the cartilage on my bones wearing? Why do I have osteoarthritis? If God made me in his image and likeness and called me good and set me apart, why is the cartilage on my bones that is supposed to be the sandwich between my bones to keep the bones nice and in perfect shape, why is it wearing? Why? That's the question you need to ask. Not to present to the facility and be given Tylenol, Naproxen, Aleve, Brufen, Fentanyl, whatever. No. Why is it happening? And all the scientists have been, the medics have been able to do so far is to tell us, you know, it's something that happens. It's a condition. It leads to inflammation and this, that. But why? 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 It means that there's something. If the fundamentals of you is your cells, there is something in your cell that is not right, which is why you're having the discomforts. This is why cellular health has now become the in thing. Because we've tried to treat issues just by dealing with it topically all this time. But right now, we have to focus on digging deeper to the root causes of the issue. Why? Why? The why question needs to be answered. And the only way to have sustained improvement in your wellness is to dig to the foundations. If you want to put up a 10-story building and you start off the project with a foundation that can only support 2-story building, if you don't take care, you won't even get to the 4th floor. Everything would just come buckling down. Why? Because there wasn't enough reinforcement to carry the load of a 10-story building on a 2-story foundation. So the weight of the concrete and the iron rods is too much for the foundation. So everything comes crumbling down. And there have been so many of those things that have happened and people have lost lives because of it. It is similar to your body. I have headache, they give you Tylenol. My tummy hurts, they give you tricyclic. I have a discomfort here. I'm diabetic, they give you metformin. All well and good. But why? What is happening? And you find that when you start to tackle the cellular issue from the cellular level and deal with your redox level, your redox signaling molecules, when those things begin to get fixed, discomforts and diseases are pushed at bay. I'm not seeing any love hearts, so I don't even know whether what I'm saying is upsetting. You're loving it. You're learning something. Whether you've shared this video, I don't know. Oh, Biko Nunu. Eh? I shouldn't be begging you to show me love now. Eh? If you love me, let it just come from your heart. Let it flow naturally. Please. I know you're enjoying what we're saying. You're seriously taking notes. But I beg you, let us share this video. Maybe you don't know, there's somebody who has osteoarthritis, serious, and is looking for something that is going to remedy the situation and help them. They can't tell you because they're embarrassed about it. A lot of us don't talk about our health issues because we're embarrassed about it. So my darling, please, please. You want me to explain redox more? So as I was saying, redox is inside you. God made you with redox in your cells. But as you age, the level of your redox signaling molecules that are made by the trillions in your cells, the cells in your body, your hair, your cheeks, your eyes, your nose, your mouth, your ears, your bobby, your nyash, every part of your body has redox signaling molecules embedded in the cells of your persona. Every part of you has cells, everything. We live and perish at the cellular level. So the day you are not here anymore, it means your redox is finished. Your cells have gone to sleep and they are not waking up again. That's okay, Tori. Go and get some sleep. But please, my darling, redox signaling molecules would continue to depreciate over time unless you top it up with more of the same. Permission to fall out. Permission granted, Tori. You can go and sleep. thank you so much for being here, darling. It continues to deteriorate over time. So if you're on this planet, you have to top up your redox signaling molecules with more of the same so that your cells can continue to function optimally. They can talk to each other, the cells in your eyes and the cells in your brain. So when one eye wants to close, the cells in your brain are telling, "I close on the right side." If you want to blink, the cells in your brain will tell eyes, blink, 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 and you blink. But if there's no coordination and signaling going on, when the brain is telling the eyes to blink, your eyes are like this. I said blink, it's still like this. Where are you going? Do you continue to take it without stop? Well, you have cells in your body that need redox. As long as you are alive, it's depleting. Perfect example. Let me ask this question. When you buy a car and you drive out of the showroom with the car, if you are lucky, because the people want you to leave the showroom, they may put $30 of fuel in the tank. When you drive the car from the showroom to your house, from your house to work, from work to church, from church to shopping, from shopping home, over 3-4 days, maybe 1 week, Abeguna, do you top up the petrol in your car or do you just park it and it keeps running indefinitely? Do you take it to the mechanic to check the oil, the water, the whatever, check the tires, change the pressures if need be? And sometimes if you're living in this part of the world, you have to put winter tires. And my sister, I don't know where you are, so it depends on when you are, where you are. But if you want more information about how to get redox signaling molecules, you need to go to redoxmiracle.tmasia.com. All the information about how to get it and how much it is and all of that, it is all there. Contact my cellular health coach, my cellular practitioner. Her name is on Facebook, is Patience O. Edwards. But if you go to redoxmiracle.tmasia.com, if somebody can type that for me, that is where you can contact her. And she, if you leave your phone number and your email address, and make sure that the phone number also includes your area code and country code, so we know where you are. Thank you so much, Pastor Patience. I don't think you've put it right, Pastor P. You put redoxmiracle.team.com. It's redoxmiracle.teamasia.com. Thank you so much, Pastor P. So please, please, you're listening to me, you're watching me. You were asking me a question about whether you have to take it forever and a day. And I'm asking, when you buy a car and you put fuel in the car, you use it to do all your rounds and you pack it, there comes a time when the fuel in your car becomes depleted and you have to top up. When you top up the petrol in your car, do you do it just one time? Or is it an ongoing thing that you keep doing? If it is ongoing, and you are also using this body of yours like a car, you are sleeping, waking up, doing number two, doing mama and papa, going to work, coming back, eating, going to church, dancing, going to nightclub, dancing, coming back, eating, playing with your children and all of that, then your body needs to be fortified with redox signaling molecules. Sister Catherine is asking whether it can be shipped to the British West Indies. This is the Caribbean, isn't it? We unfortunately don't ship to the Caribbean and Africa as yet. It is not in Africa. It is not in the Caribbean at all yet. The closest to it is the United States, Sister Catherine. So that would be the way to get it if you're over there. It's in Canada, the States, all of Europe, the Philippines, Hong Kong. Malaysia. But unfortunately, we're not in Africa yet. It doesn't get shipped to Africa. It doesn't get shipped to the Caribbean. Unfortunately, yet. But you know, you can still share this video. You see, when there's enough of awareness made about this, and enough people, there's enough interest, there's enough demand for it, you can now go and say, Biko Nunu, please, so let us share, let us ship this product to this place. There's a warm market ready and available to get this product. Please, let's do this. So please share this video so that there can be enough people and enough awareness about it so that people can want to have the product and do what needs to happen. But if there's any parting words before I jump off this video in the next 10 minutes, all I would say to you is that you have one life to live and you get to choose how you're going to live the life. Buying a house is important. Acquiring assets, very beautiful. And the most important asset you can acquire for yourself is your wellness, is your health, is fortifying yourself and ensuring that all the things that need to be at bay are at bay. If you think today that you're in your 20s, 30s, 40s, even 50s, and you don't have any issue. Oh, me, I won't have any problem. You know, I'll just be okay. I've never even had a headache my whole life. Yeah, okay. But what if you don't do anything? And then something catastrophic suddenly happens to you that is so bad that you can't even pick up phone to call me or Pastor Patience to say, I'm ready, I surrender, I want this product. Very important point here. When I started this live video, I mentioned that I started my Redox journey 16 months ago when Pastor Patience exposed me to the product. This is something that I'm going to ingest inside my body. This is something I'm going to be applying to my body, to my skin on a regular basis. I have to make sure now that this product is from a reputable place. Like I'm getting the actual product and not imitation. Because these days, everything can be imitated. Anything. You know it. So something that you're going to be ingesting inside of you, you need to make sure that it's coming from the right source and it's actually the product that I'm talking about. If you listen to me and you go and Google something and it takes you to some third-party website on Etsy or eBay or Facebook Market or some other place, obscure place, and you go and say that I heard Seeker talk about Redox, so I went to buy Redox. What did you buy? What did you buy? Because the only source that I know that I can put my name to and say, hey, this is my reputation on the line. This is Pastor Patience's reputation on the line. No, but this is where you need to go. This is where I get it from. Myself. So I can only show you what I've done. I'm giving you the blue script. Exactly what I did is what I'm telling you. So if you now deviate and you go and do something else and you have different results, is it fair to now blame me that you heard me talk about Redox and you went to buy Redox and it doesn't work? Do you know what you took? My sister, please. TeamAsia.com, RedoxMiracle.TeamAsia.com. Pastor Patience put it there. Please, RedoxMiracle.TeamAsia.com. That is where I get my products from on a monthly basis for the last 16 months and counting. So please, don't do anything different. And then come and blame me that, oh, that thing that she was talking about, it's all a hoax. It's not true. Because I don't know what you took. There is somebody who did what I'm telling you not to do. She came and heard us talking about Redox, Pastor Patience and I talking about Redox, and she went and Googled it over Sabi. She went to go and Google it, and then she went to her own place. I don't even know where she got it from. She started ingesting this thing, and she was nearly deleted from this planet. If anything happens to you like that, how can you come and blame me? When I've already told you that it is redoxmiracle.teamasia.com, that is where you should go. That is the only site that I can vouch for and put my name on the line for, because I know that what I'm taking is what you're also taking. But if you go and do something else, then me, I don't know what you did. And it gets even more interesting. People will go and do their own thing. Then when they finish, they come and ask you, so I got my own redox, so how should I take it? What answer do you want me to give you? Do I know what you bought? Did you buy it from me? Did you go to the source that I told you to go to? Why do you think you've earned the right for me to waste my time telling you how you should take it? Wherever you got it from, shouldn't you ask them? Shouldn't you ask them what you should do? We don't sell it out there. And you need a cellular health practitioner, because you need to be guided on what to do on the basis of your discomfort and where your cellular level is. For instance, let's say you have really high blood pressure, or your sugar level, you have some chronic issue. Your body is in a very destabilized place. You have to be guided about what to do and how to do it. You've heard me talking extensively about, I've been applying something on my body. But if you don't know where to even put this thing, Pastor Patience has some fantastic places that when you apply this thing to those specific places, magic happens. I've been telling you about Bula Matali all day today. If you apply this thing to some specific places and you have Bula Matali and Punani issues, you will thank me later. These and many more are the reasons why you need to be guided. You don't just get up on your own and just read instructions, because only you know how to read. We all can read. So you just read, apply it, whatever, to your body and that's it. No, that is just, they have to put something as a direction on the back of the thing. That is a generic dosage. That you have your own peculiar issues, and you're taking this thing to deal with those issues. So the way Pastor Patience will prescribe that to you will be different from my own prescription, her own prescription, somebody else's prescription. My darling, obedience is better than sacrifice. Don't try to circumvent anything, cut corners. I don't understand that sometimes. Redoxmiracle.teamasia.com. That is where to go. Then you just decide that, let me just Google it. Like, what makes you think like that? I'm just trying to understand why we do that. Simple instruction. Redoxmiracle.teamasia.com. Very simple. Just go there. Ask for the product. And let the cellular health practitioner, somebody who's taken enough training and knows what she's doing, help you do the right thing so that you can have results. Your discomfort and diseases can be at bay and you can be happy enough to come back and thank God for what he's done for you. Because me now, every day I'm dancing. And what the doctor said was impossible, because of God and redox, it's now possible in my life. I can boogie and go down and up and not stay. Let me watch my thing. I don't want any twinges to happen. When my crazy Russian friends get here now and we are all boogieing to Afrobeats, I don't have to worry. Those girls are crazy. Right? So please, 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 I beg you, follow simple instructions. Do the right thing. Just follow it to the T by the book, so that you can have the desired results that you need. I am taking redox for the rest of my life. As long as redox exists, I'm having it. Because only I know what popping pill every day, as opposed to not popping, what it means to me. So please, I am still recovering. There's still a lot to happen. 16 months is not enough time. For cells that have been in on child support, on life support for 3 decades and some, to recover. That is my own personal story. Do what works for you. But when you come to really experience redox in all its fullness and regalia, trust me, you won't need anybody to tell you that this is a product I need to stay on. Because I love how I'm feeling so much that I don't want to not feel like that anymore. When people who can't do mama and papa to their spouses anymore are suddenly able to do it, you think you want to really risk doing 6:30 again? Eh? For your wife to pack bag and baggage and leave just because of redox that you've refused to use. Does it make sense? Obedience is better than sacrifice. It's the truth. It costs you something. It costs you something. So, my darling, just do the simplest thing that you have to do. Redoxmiracle.teamasia.com. Just go there. If you want more information about, you know, the products, go to redoxscience.com. And knock yourself out. There's so much research. You can read. Knock yourself out. But please, oh, take action. Some of us will say we're going to do something, and then all of a sudden, something else crops in, and then it's like you've put that something to one side. This is your health we are talking about here. Can't gamble on it. You can't take any risk. You can't do anything. But do what is right to be done. And so, my darling, I've waffled on for long enough. I hope that it's clear. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask the questions. I haven't seen any love hearts, so I'm guessing that I'm not loved and it's fine. And I'm not seeing anybody sharing this video. But this is a life saver. Mr. Kenneth, please send me a message privately because I need to jump off this video. Otherwise, I'm going to pass out. So please send me a message and let's message each other back and forth back door. I can't repeat everything myself. Mikonono, please. I've been here for 4 hours today. My eyes hurt. So please, let me go and rest my cells. Oh, I've been telling you to rest. Let me rest my own cells. But please send me a private message and I'll respond to that. And I'll explain to you what we've been talking about, you might want to go back and also watch the video because it's very self-explanatory. And there was a video that was done earlier. It talked about marriage, but there was a lot of redox things that was also infused in there. So please don't miss those videos. I love you so much, my brothers and my sisters. I'm having the best life that I've had in a very long time. And slowly but surely, my cells are knitting themselves slowly but surely back together again. And it's only a matter of time. If in 16 months this is what I'm seeing, in another 16 months from now, oh la la. It's redoxmiracle.teamasia.com. I'll send you, private message me, Miss Jane Okafor, please send me a private message and I'll respond to you, okay? Yeah. But it's redoxmiracle.teamasia.com. Uncle Raymond, I would respond to your message. I saw your message. I would respond. God bless you all so much. Thank you for everything that you have done, continue to do, for all the love, for sharing this video. Please share this video. I beg you. Share this video. Osteoarthritis is a very severe, debilitating condition. Please share this video. Unfortunately, I can't put osteoarthritis. If I do that, this video is not going anywhere in a hurry. So you might see that my videos don't have no medical terminologies associated with it because social media, Facebook, they have their own standards. So please share this video. If you keep watching these videos, you will catch things when you need to catch them. But please share this video. Redoxscience.com is where to read about it. If you're ready to embark on your redox journey, it's redoxmiracle.teamasia.com. Pastor P, please put the website for getting the products one more time, please. I don't know why it doesn't have the ability for the whoever is doing the live video to be able to type themselves like it is on StreamYard. But Pastor Patience will put the website one more time. redoxmiracle.teamasia.com. So Miss Jane, so you have access to that and you can contact Pastor Patience that way. Thank you so much, Pastor P. You will be fine, Sister Catherine. You will be fine. God bless you. And God restore you and meet you at your point of need. He is all-knowing and will meet you at your point of need. And I pray that you can come to a country that we are at so that you can experience redox for your own self. And trust me, yeah, it is an awesome, awesome scientific biotech product. It's not some magical something. It's not a holy water or some, you know, it doesn't have any mystery based anything to it. It's not anointing oil. It's not holy water. It's none of that. This is a scientific biotech product. That's what it is. Made by pure science. Pure science. And it's been around for over a decade and a half. And our Onibo counterparts have known about it. Our Asian counterparts have known about it. And have been ingesting it all this time. And experiencing high level wellness in their bodies. But people that look like you and me are last to the party all the time. So we are now, only now, just finding out about it. Don't waste any more time. Prioritize yourself. if you want to age backwards, eh? If you want to be in a 40-year-old body and have a 30-year-old energy, you need to start redoxing soon, Papa Nkechi. So that Mama Chioma will be happy with you all the time. And be begging you to stop because she's had enough. Eh, that's a nicer place to be. Than to have big Bula Matali that you cannot use for anything. And be annoying Mama Chioma all the time. A word to the wise is enough. But I need to jump off this video. Because I need to go and rest my body and do what needs to happen. So I love you all so much. Have a fantastic day. And please think about what I've said and take the necessary action. Take the necessary action. Pastor Patience, God bless you. Mr. Jeff, God bless you. Nimchak, God bless you. Mr. Amaichi, God bless you. Isata, God bless you. Kevin, Mr. Samuel, Sister Catherine, Sister Bernice, Yogi, Emmanuel, Ambrose, Edmore, Howard. God bless every single one of you. I love you so much. Mwah. Bye for now.